Hi everyone, it's Andy from Hobby Headquarters. Well, today I want to share with you, granted it's a project that's a little bit different than what we normally do, but something that I think is really, really cool. The other day I was looking to get a new desk light for my work area where I build most of my models here in the store. And I remembered that my older son had made for my younger son a light just like this, this robot light for his dorm. And I thought this is the perfect opportunity. I think it's the coolest looking little desk lamp you can find. And it's made out of just parts that you can get like at a home center that will have like plumbing and electrical. And with some basic stuff, you can put together this light very, very easily. And it's just a cool desk piece. I've had it here in the store for a few days and got lots and lots of compliments on it. Everyone's like, that is really cool looking. In fact, it reminds me, if you guys have ever been to Star Tours at Disney World or Disneyland, the robot that used to be in the queue of Star Tours at the very beginning. It looks just like that to me and fully works. You can put, I happen to have one of the Edison style bulbs, an LED one with all the extra filament inside. I think those are really cool looking, and it has kind of a yellow light to it, but I'm going to show you today. It's going to be a short video. I'll break down all the parts that you will need. One disclaimer I want to make note. Obviously, you do have to work with electrical parts. And I am not an expert on electrical. I know what I was doing on this purpose right here. But if you have any questions whatsoever, definitely go seek somebody out that knows how to do wiring, because it obviously can be dangerous if you don't do it correctly. But like I was saying, it's a cool project. It's something we can do pretty simply. And let's get started. Okay, I'm going to break down the parts that you're going to be needed to do one just like this. Now, obviously, you can go ahead and make adjustments to different arm size, leg size. All that stuff can be adjusted. The first thing you need is a junction box. I'm using all metal on this particular build. And this particular one has three knockouts on each side, a knockout on the top, a knockout on the bottom, and then knockouts on the back. And you're going to need at least one that has two knockouts on the side, obviously for arms and legs, head, and then a knockout for the back for where the plug is going to come out. So we've got the junction box right there. We're going to need a light switch. Then we are going to need some 90 degree elbows, and I'm using all half inch on this. Obviously you can use bigger sizes to make a bigger robot. So we're going to need four of these, and that's going to have the two elbows and the two hips. Then we also need two threaded nipples. This part right here, this is going to be the leg portion right here, and you can make these as long as you want. Just remember, we don't want to make it too top heavy that it's going to fall over. So I use the 1 inch. Then we have two end caps, also in half inch. These are going to be his hands. These right here, these are 3/8 floor plates. Now, everything else we were using was half inch, but I stepped down on the floor plates because the floor plates start to get really large for the half inch. So we use 3/8, and to mate those together, we have an adapter. So this is a half inch to 3/8 adapter. And that's when you're going to screw this in. Well, I'll show that in a minute. So you're going to need two of the feet. And finally, you're also going to need, two of these nipples. These are nipples that have no center part in it right here. And these are the regular half inch on that. So we need two of those. We also need a light switch cover, which will cover that up right there. And you're also going to need 10 of these. These right here are conduit lock nuts. And they thread on, and that's what's going to keep everything tight together. So I bought actually a bag of 20, so it worked out perfectly. 10 for each one of the robots we're going to build. We have our light feature right here. You're also going to need a cable connector, just like this. This is going to mount into the back of the piece to hold the cord in place. An extension cord. We're going to use this. We're just going to cut the end off of this to use this as the wiring for it. A wire nut. And then the tools are pretty simple. We're going to need a screwdriver, a hammer, a couple of pair of wrenches, and if you have one, a wire stripper. Makes it a lot easier to strip the wires out. Okay, we're going to start off by knocking out the holes that we need on it here. So we obviously need to do that for the leg, that for the arm, this one for the head, same thing on this side. Also, keep in mind, some of these have a top and bottom. So we want the cord to come out of the bottom of this. So make sure that this is the one you knock out for the head. So we want to remove this one right here for the cord, and we don't need to leave the bottom one out. So the quickest and easiest way to knock these out, take a screwdriver, hit it with a hammer, and then we just grab a pair of pliers from the inside so we don't cut ourselves and just pull those out. So I'm going to take those outside and do that right now. Quick note too, when you're applying these threaded pieces inside, be very careful. Some of those threads can be very, very sharp and can cut you very easily. So if you can get a pair of pliers and grab it and tighten them up that way without damaging any more of the threads. So here we have our two arms all built up. Okay, for the electrical cord for the light, we're just going to use an extension cord. We're going to cut the end off here. Pull the two wires apart like that. And this is that tool I was telling you about that makes it just so much nicer to strip wires. Just like that. So now we can run them through the back of the robot's opening here. And then we'll run feed the wires through, and then we'll hook up the light switch. Okay, we've got them all wired up here, and before we close them up, we're going to test to make sure everything is all right. And sure enough, it is. And I just went ahead and put a little LED light bulb in there right now to test this out, but obviously you can put any kind you want in there. And just like that, we have our light all built up. Now there's obviously a whole bunch of different ways we can customize this. We can put longer pipes in the legs, make them taller, longer arms. You can put a basket cage over the light bulb itself. You could also turn this into a dog or cat-like animal too by twisting this leg around, putting the extension and elbows and knees on it like this, and putting extra feet. Taking another one of these elbows, putting it up on the top here before you attach the light, and you could have like a little dog type animal. You can also change out the switch here. You could put another electrical plug inside here, or even a USB adapter in there as well to charge your phone or other items like that. So I think this is going to make a great desktop light. As you can see, I've got two different types of bulbs in there. I do have two of these. I'll probably change that out. I like this big giant bulb on top of his head there. But I want to thank you guys as always for watching, and please stay tuned because we have many more videos coming.